Very important information just coming in. A former U.S. Air Force intelligence specialist is charged with turning against her country, becoming a spy for Iran. Monica Witt is accused of helping Iran identify and target American counterintelligence officers. Our Pentagon correspondent Barbara Starr is reporting from the Middle East right now. She's joining us live from Oman. Barbara, first of all, tell us more about these spy charges.
Well, Wolf, espionage is always the ultimate betrayal, but this time especially painful because it's espionage on behalf of Iran.
Tonight, a former U.S. Air Force intelligence specialist who disappeared and was believed to be in Iran is now wanted by the FBI for spying on behalf of the Islamic Republic. 39-year-old Monica Witt, who had access to top-secret information, including names of U.S. intelligence officers, defected to Iran in 2013 and was once thought to be missing. But instead, the Justice Department says she was recruited by Iran's Islamic Revolutionary Guard Corps.
Monica Witt provided the Iranian government with the identities of employees in the U.S. intelligence community who were operating covertly.
The Justice Department says Witt worked with Iran to target at least 8 U.S. government agent computer accounts in order to deploy malware that would provide access to computers and networks used by the U.S. intelligence community. The U.S. also alleges Witt created target packages for Iran to identify and track down U.S. government agents. This week, Iran marks 40 years since the Islamic Revolution brought the current regime to power. And the rhetoric from the Trump administration is getting hotter.
I don't think you'll have many more anniversaries to enjoy.
But I appreciate you, John.
The hawkish language from National Security Advisor John Bolton is at odds with the Pentagon, according to a senior military official. The official said the military is seeking to avoid open conflict with Iran and rely instead on economic and diplomatic pressure. But in an exclusive television interview, the top Navy commander for the region says the threat is real.
They have a growing capability in cruise missiles. They have a growing capability in ballistic missiles. They have a growing capability in unmanned surface systems.
CNN went aboard the USS Gladiator, one of the Navy's mine countermeasure ships in the Persian Gulf, where the crew faces the threat Iran poses to the U.S. and shipping in this critical area.
We are prepared for everything that they actually have and everything that their rhetoric says that they have.
For the commanding officer of USS Gladiator, the mission is making sure that if Iran lays mines in the vital Strait of Hormuz waterway, the ship will be able to find and destroy them.
We take it as a threat that is something that could happen and that we need to be ready for and prepared for.
U.S. military officials say that some of the new Russian missiles and weapon systems going into Iran are so strong with long ranges, very powerful, that it means the U.S. military may have to change the way it conducts operations in the vital Persian Gulf waterways sometime in the next 5 years. Wolf?
Lots of important stuff. Barbara Starr reporting exclusively for us from the Persian Gulf in Oman. Thank you very much.